Your Guide to Owning and Operating a Hospitality Property Successfully. Independent Hotel, Resort, Inn, or Bed and Breakfast. Written by Gerry MacPherson. Narrated by Gerry MacPherson. Copyright Keystone Hospitality Property Development. Dedication. This book is dedicated to my lovely wife Sandra, my mom Effie, my two children, Scott and Jillian, and my granddaughter, Lumen, who have all had to deal with my years on the road. It's also dedicated to potential and current independent hotel, resort, inn, and bed and breakfast owners and managers who love the hospitality property industry, but are not big fans of all the hassles that come with it. The goal of this book is to ease that burden. Introduction. How do I open or how do I grow my hotel, resort, inn, or bed and breakfast? This is a question I'm often asked, but before I answer, let me begin by asking you a couple of questions. Is the idea of being your own boss sound appealing to you? Is the thought of sharing your corner of the world with guests intriguing? Have you ever thought about owning and operating your own independent hotel, resort, inn, or bed and breakfast, but are not sure the steps to take to ensure success? If you've answered yes to any of these questions, this book is for you. If you have dreams of becoming a successful independent hotel, resort, inn, or bed and breakfast proprietor, this book is designed to get you started and to grow your business. Now, before we start, let me tell you a little bit about ourselves. Who are we? We are Keystone Hospitality Development Consulting, a group of travel experts that have come together with decades of hospitality property, hotels, resorts, inns, and bed and breakfasts, visitation experience. We have spent thousands of nights in properties of all sizes and classes worldwide, conducting countless site inspections for a number of world-class tour and travel companies, as well as receive feedback from hundreds of thousands of customers. This knowledge has given us a unique insight into the wants, needs, and requirements of individual and group travelers, as well as management and employees. We understand what it takes to make a hospitality property successful, as well as practices that can ensure failure. This book is designed to get you started on the right track, and if followed, when you open the doors to your independent hotel, resort, inn, or bed and breakfast, you'll be well on your way to becoming successful. Where to start? For the sake of this book, I'm going to assume you are either starting from scratch or are hoping to grow your current business. Let's go through a step-by-step process. Sleep around. Visit other hospitality properties in the area you're considering to open. Talk with the owners and find out their pros and cons. Don't be rushed to find the right location. If you're dealing with a real estate agent, find one that's willing to take the time to find you the best deal. If you're feeling pressured by them, my first instinct is to walk away. Study the surroundings. I once chatted with a gentleman who wanted to buy a hospitality property sitting on a cliff overlooking the Atlantic Ocean. The building was in great shape, beautiful view, and loyal clientele, and the current owner was willing to sell for a very low price. He wanted to know my opinion, so I asked him what the rate of cliff erosion was. He had no idea and admitted he never took it into consideration. Upon further checking, we found the cliff was eroding at an average of 3 meters or 3 yards a year, and at that rate, he would have to move his property within 10 years. That was a cost he had not considered and passed on the deal. Examples of how elements could affect your site? Is the area prone to flooding? Where do the winds come from? Other considerations could be, is there industry in the area? Heavy traffic or livestock farms nearby? You have to be aware of the noise and potential smell. Before committing to a site, visit it a number of different days and times so you totally understand what your guests will experience. Make sure your design fits. Building an independent hotel, resort, inn, or bed and breakfast in an industrial zone are probably not the best ways to attract your ideal guest. Is there an infrastructure in place? Do the roads make your property easily accessible? Is there usable public transportation? Are there things for your guests to do, restaurants or attractions? Details like this are extremely important. All right, you found the right spot. Before you do any building or renovating, you have to decide who is your target market. Are they going to be vacationer or business travelers? Young or old? Wealthy or budget travelers? You should have your target market in mind and not try to be everything to everyone. Now that you know your target market, you're going to have to determine their needs. And this can be done by researching other properties targeting your market, trends, and technology. When designing your hotel, resort, inn, or bed and breakfast, it'll be worth your while to hire an architect or designer who understands the hospitality property industry. Interview them away from your site, their office, and ask to see the work they've done. When you feel comfortable with your choice, then bring them to your site. Use the appropriate consultants as necessary. For example, interior designer, structural, landscapers, electrical, etc. Benefit from their expertise, but remember, you're in charge. Overseeing this kind of development can be very time-consuming, so if you're unable to do it yourself, hire someone you trust to manage the project. Create a budget and stick to it. Walk and visualize everything. You want to draw out every aspect of your property, and an even better option would be to have a three-dimensional model built. You want to understand how all aspects of your property will work together before the first nail is hammered or concrete is poured. I had mentioned you need to have a budget and stick to it, but it's also important to be flexible when necessary. Set a schedule and an end date. Make sure everyone involved agrees to and signs to the schedule and completion dates, keeping in mind any outside factors that could influence this time frame. For example, holidays or legal requirements. Frequently visit the site to make sure there are no surprises, and as each operational area is finished, do a walk around, looking at it as your guests would. When the building renovations are almost complete, you might be thinking, I can hardly wait to open the doors and invite the world in. Everything's almost done. Not so fast. Your property might almost be ready, but now you need an organizational strategy in place. In the next chapter, we are going to be looking at setting up your organizational strategy. What is the hospitality property industry? The foremost focus is customer satisfaction, and this can play an important role in both leisure and business. A welcoming, substantial reception and entertainment for guests, visitors, or strangers, extending not only to hospitality properties, but anyone who wishes to provide customer satisfaction. Without satisfaction, an organization would quickly lose customers. That said, the hospitality property sector is more heavily reliant than any other on customer satisfaction. You have to think of customer satisfaction not being the marketing tool, but instead the main service offered. What does hospitality mean for hospitality properties? For hospitality property owners or staff members, your goal is to ensure your guest experience at your property is excellent. In a hospitality property setting, your guests exist to be served. You as a provider exist to serve. A provider succeeds when they make a guest feel comfortable and catered to. It's delivering this experience that brings guests back and drives repeat revenue. For your guests, hospitality is the thing that buffers their anxiety, monotony, or fatigue and treats them with enjoyment and relaxation. It gives them an experience that replaces other emotions from the day. They're willing to pay for it and are only satisfied if their expectations are met with the service they receive. For hospitality to be good as a guest, they have to feel comfortable and well served. Think about it this way. Hospitality is the guest experience, a combination of items offered.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.